beyond 20 years in practice, I did what you're meant to do and reflect. And the people that I'd most enjoyed treating and also most been frustrated by were my chronic headache patients. And so I was on the merry-go-round that might be familiar to you as well. Or maybe, you know, you all get fantastic results with all of them, in which case we'd really like to hear from you. And not that I think I was doing anything wrong, I was doing what I was taught to do. And I'm not going to read off my PowerPoint, so you can see where I was at. I was doing the usual things, trying on still quite a lot of time, but like good results. Who gets pretty good results with their headache patients? So it's really rewarding, isn't it? It makes a big difference in people's lives when you do well with them. But they do tend to come back. So partly obviously that was my expectations and partly that was I didn't understand the situation. So I thought I'd do a bit of reading up and I didn't find much out there. CPD in the osteopathic world on headaches was really lacking. And so I trained as a teacher meantime and finally I got a job at the ESA, which is really lovely. And my first week trying to clinic tutor and ESO, who should I see but a horrendously afflicted migraineur. Who I would have sent immediately for a scan, she was in such a bad way, but it was just, you know, that's what habits, I thought, right, that's it, I have to find the cause, because I don't know if any of you clinic tutor, but it's really scary being in front of a lot of expectant faces not knowing what to do. So, on the same day that I decided that, I discovered there was a new course at the University of Edinburgh, and it was basically a master's in headaches, and I thought it was a bit ambitious, and I was sure they wouldn't have me, but they did, so they must have been desperate. So there I was, it's an online course, and which no longer runs as such. It was possible to do it as a one-year PGCE, so I now have two, which is good. And we went through all kinds of things I didn't think I needed to know about, like headache epidemiology, and endless stuff on classification. I mean, really everything has a name, and headache specialists are really, they're not happy until they've named the beast, because then there's a treatment protocol. And it took me a long time to appreciate that, but really, unless you have diagnosis, you can't take the next step. And so classification, diagnosis, very important. And we spent a lot of time on migraine, and it's actually what you, if you become known for treating headache patients, or patients with headaches, because we don't treat conditions, you will find that the mainstay of your work is migraine of some sort. And that covers a huge variety of things. So because I'm well over 50, I thought, well, I better teach this stuff before I forget it. So I was very lucky to have the support of the ESO to start another headache clinic here. And it basically works as one-to-one tuition, but I hope in future we'll have some headache material on the curriculum. I'm working on it. There are people out there who think that headache study is really for die-hard, nerdy postgraduates long into their practice. I disagree, and I have some really enthusiastic students who come early on Saturday morning. Here we've got 11. We did a barefoot day, we had about 60. And the enthusiasm and appetite for it is unbelievable, not least because I think, you know, some of them suffer too, and they know, you know, what a difficult scenario it is. So we have the ESO headache clinic here on a Wednesday night, and we've seen all kinds of different headache types, and I just feel better that the people are becoming exposed to this, and they go out into practice, they're not going to be so flummoxed. Currently, out there in the big wide world, this is one of the algorithms from MIPCA. When I first put that into Google, I found that the Michigan Institute of Pest Control. So you need to put in MIPCA headaches, and then you'll get this. And you can also find it on the Migraine Action website. If you look under the professionals page, Migraine Action is a very helpful resource. All this will be on the website, on the PESA website. So you have to look really hard to find where we are. Can you see where we are? I'm right in the middle there. I'm not sure if I have that's the point of it. Oh yes, look at that. Here we are. We're very small one. There's somewhere in the alternative therapies, in amongst the hands-on ones, it's osteopathy. So we're really nothing special in headaches as the outside world would have it. And I think it would be great to change that. And I'm not a headache expert, but I really welcome the involvement and engagement with this subject so that we can get better at it, talk the language of the medics as well, and become better known for being helpful in the world of headaches. So what I found was when I had the tutorials at the ESO, I'll be quick, sorry, was that the tutors were coming as well. We had lunchtime tutorials with students, and I see a row of tutors at the back. So I thought they wanted to make sure I knew what I was talking about. But actually, they wanted to know what I was talking about. And so I got together with some colleagues, and to cut a very long story short, we founded Osteopathic Progress in Headaches and Migraines, OPHM. It doesn't roll off the tongue. We had lots of better names, which were funny. But this one, so the progress part is we want momentum here. And so it's been a very busy year. We've just had our first official birthday in November. We presented the headline day at the Institute of Osteopathy convention last year. And we had well over 150 people attending a day long, and that was amazing. So there obviously is the appetite for it. And what you get at the moment when you join is a very early form of what the website will be ultimately, but one of the main benefits to you is the link with the Migraine World Summit videos. They're really interesting. They're world experts just talking about their work and sharing their insights. And I read something on the train this morning about the philosophy of science, and Bacon in 1620 said that that science is as much about shedding light as it is about making things happen. And so we hope to shed light for you today and to connect you with lots of interesting aspects of our work to expand your headache toolkit. And one of the nicest things we've done to date is case sharing meetings. They're really relaxed, friendly. Please come along, bring your difficult cases or bring your interesting cases. Come and share, and they will happen in different parts of the country as we build up our numbers. And I'm now going to introduce to you Mark McWilliams, who is a very experienced honorary lecturer in headaches at Cardiff University, osteopath, and prize winner in was it 2009 for the Welsh?
2011.
11, sorry. Welsh Pain Society, is that right? You can talk about yourself. So thank you, Mark.